Hello everybody and welcome to a special show today. Today we have with us Rajesh Jayaraman, the Deputy Head Product Management from Nippon India Mutual Fund. We are going to talk about their new NFO offering, which is the Nippon India Passive FlexiCap Fund of Fund. This fund offer is open up to the 24th of December and we are going to talk from Rajesh and understand some of the key aspects of this fund offer. Hi Rajesh, welcome to Radio Dwarka.
Hi Ruchi, thank you for having us here.
Rajesh, I'm just going to quickly ask you a couple of things about the fund offer because, you know, it sounds quite interesting and it is something which is not usually seen in this within the mutual fund space. So quickly, I'd like to understand what are some of the three or four top features of this fund or the offer that you have.
So I'll take a couple of minutes here, Ruchi. Before I come to the product, let me tell you how we conceived this whole idea. Because normally, and that will answer the question also. See, basically what happens is for any investor, there are three questions which are eternal. So it doesn't matter what time, when, what kind of market conditions, these questions always plague their minds. First is this the right time? Especially when it comes to equities. There is always this question of, is this the right time? Especially today, we are talking in the context of some of the indices touching all-time highs. But I say this to everybody that even if we had this discussion, say, 8 months back in the month of March, even then the question would have been same because then things were looking pretty gloomy because the pandemic had just set in and people didn't know. So first question is this the right time? Second question is, if somebody believes that, okay, the timing is still doesn't matter, I'm convinced about equity. The second question is, where should I invest? Because when we talk about equities, that's a larger basket. Divided broadly, you have three subsegments. You have a large cap, mid cap, small cap kind of companies. Where should I invest? The third is, which fund should I select? And each of them comes with its own challenges. First one about markets, all of us know that there is timing. It is very, very difficult. Nobody gets it right all the time. The same is true for even the market cap performance because that can be very divergent. So 2 years back, nobody knew that large caps would be so good. Or in 2017, the mid caps, small caps were outperforming significantly. So this kind of cycles keep changing. And therein the learning is, if you have a multi-cap kind of approach, if you invest across these three segments, the potential of generating a superior experience, better wealth over long run is that much better or higher. And the third question I said is very important. Which fund to invest? Because what we have seen with an active fund means a fund which is the normal mutual fund in normal parlance, in lay parlance. The attempt by each fund manager there is to try and beat the benchmark. So naturally, if you want to better something, you will have a positioning which is different. Right. And again, it works in phases. So you'll never see one single fund consistently being a number one fund at all points of time. So that keeps changing. Because of which people can have different experiences depending upon when they got into a particular fund. So if we can get a product which answers all these three problems and gives one single solution, it could be an interesting approach and something which some of the investors might like, and there could be an appetite for this kind of an offering. So that's exactly what we're trying to do. One, we are saying from a longer term perspective, it's very, very difficult to outsmart the markets. So market knowledge in that sense is supreme. So what strategy we are adopting here is we will invest into the funds or strokes, index funds, stroke exchange traded funds. What this is in very simple terms, they just track the market. So they will track an underlying benchmark index. So what we are saying is the large cap, mid cap, small cap allocations, which we'll do here, we will just track the markets. And we admit that from a longer term perspective, market wisdom is always supreme. This is the first part of it. The second part of it is where I said it's difficult to identify the funds, and hence having an allocation across these three segments could be one way to beat that. The other is we will benefit from the industry wisdom. See, what we have observed is the multi-cap category, which is a category in the part of the mutual funds, which actually follow this principle of investing across the three segments, large cap, mid cap, and small cap. The allocation which they do to these segments have been very, very in tune with the market context. So they have got it right more often than not as a category. Individually, funds would have got it right, got it wrong at various points of time. But collectively, the category has managed to get this trend very, very beautifully. In the sense, when large caps are doing well, the large cap allocation went higher. Similarly, when mid caps did well, the mid cap allocation was higher. So that kind of thing. So therein, we will trust the industry wisdom. So what we will do is we will invest into markets here, just track the market benchmarks here, which is called a passive strategy. Technically, we'll call it a passive investment style, passive investment strategy, because we're just going to replicate the market. But the allocation part, how much should be large cap, how much should be mid cap, how much should be small cap, is a dynamic thing. So therein, we come in with an active kind of element here. So the blend of passive and active styles. And there again, we are saying standalone, I may not be always correct as a house. So there could be times when I may be right, at times when I could be a little wrong. But that's not the point. The idea is here to try and benefit from the overall industry wisdom. So what it does, it benefits from the collective wisdom of the markets, both from an investment style and from an allocation pattern. But the allocation here is dynamic. Every month, this will be rebalanced. So the unique feature is this, that we believe a product like this can be a fill it, shut it, forget it kind of product for an investor. It's a single one-stop solution. You come in, don't apply too much of brains. The experience which you get is going to be far more superior is what we believe. We did some backtesting numbers from data crunching to get a sense as to how this would have done. What we saw, the investment experience generally would have been far more smoother in a strategy like this.
Okay. So I think, Rajesh, you've actually put me to think about a couple of more points while you mentioned that. And that's about, because I was going to think, when I read this features, when I read the features, I think the first thing that kicked my mind was, normally we hear mutual funds talk about multi-caps. So what, but you've talked about flexi-cap. So what do you mean by flexi-cap here? Versus a multi-cap, because normally all investors would have heard about multi-cap, but why flexi-cap?
Actually, it's quite simple. It's just that we already have a multi-cap fund, which is an active strategy. Okay. So wherein the fund manager takes active calls based on his or her views. And accordingly, the fund will run some kind of a different position vis-a-vis the benchmark. So just to differentiate that, because if we had two funds with the name of multi-cap, you could have called this passive multi-cap fund of funds. But somewhere the investor could have got confused between this fund and that fund. So just to avoid that confusion, we kept it flexi-cap. It's just a coincidence that SEBI recently announced a flexi-cap category. So that's slightly different. But for simplicity's sake, this fund will only track the multi-cap category of the mutual fund. So even though the name is flexi-cap, we will be tracking the multi-cap fund from a reference point of allocation into the market cap. So how much large cap, mid cap, small cap allocation. For that, reference point will come from the category average of the multi-cap category, which is prevalent in the mutual fund.
Okay. So, but here you're not defining any percentage fixed from a big, a large cap, small cap, mid cap. That's not what you're defining here.
We are not defining, but in a way, what you said is how it will happen. Because as the category aligns itself to the new multi-cap norms, which will be in effect from Jan 21 onwards, What will happen is the category average also will be to that extent minimum 25% in each of the market caps.
Okay, got it.
And the balance 25% is a flexibility element. So what you will see is possibly large cap on average being 45, mid caps maybe 25 to 30, small cap being 25 to 30, that kind of a range. So that is how this will work on a steady state basis going forward.
Okay. And Rajesh, because a lot of people in today's time, because of the changing environment of the market and the situations that are there, people are looking for more safer options, right? Or maybe a more place where they kind of get more defined kind of a return on their investments. So how would you like to kind of put your product for those kind of people? And what is the advantage if they have to come out of their thought process?
Couple of things here. One, moment you say defined returns, you know the kind of rates we are today from an interest rate perspective, one of the lowest ever interest rates we have seen for this country at least. So naturally, the fixed income bearing products, whatever it is, or relatively safer kind of options will offer you a lower range of returns. But obviously, that comes with a lot more predictability. A product like this actually falls in the equity basket. So moment you say equities, all of us understand the volatility levels are going to be higher. Returns cannot be predicted with such a big certainty because it's not very secular. What you will have is one or two very good years, one or two not so great years. So it will be a mixed bag. But over the long run, what you've seen is equity can be one of the better assets to create wealth from an investor's perspective. So that is where this product comes in. But where it will differ, because it's a passive strategy, it says market knows the best. So we will just replicate the market indices. So the chances of it having a big divergence with markets is very, very less. So to performance, we broadly in line with the market performance. Whereas with active funds, you, as I said, there are phases both ups and downs for each of the active funds. So people get different experiences based on that as to when they came in and what phase they went through. Whereas with this, you will have a similar like market-like experience. At the same time, on the allocation part, there's an active element. See, some investor can even do it on its own, argument sake. But the problem for them would be, would they be that dynamic to do these changes on a monthly basis? Point number one. Point number two, when they do it at an individual level, they will have taxation challenges coming in. So people again would hold themselves back. So all this is an inbuilt feature of this product. So I'm giving a complete package solution to the investor.
And I'm sure people come to mutual fund only to kind of get away from their own hassle, you know, in terms of really understanding or timing the market. That's the benefit of mutual fund. And, you know, it's mutual fund, as I always feel, is a place where you don't have to rack your brain. You have somebody to rack the brain from you for yourself. So I think that that definitely is there. Rajesh, just a question here, because, you know, we've been talking about a passive fund. And, you know, from an investor perspective, is really passive beneficial or more active beneficial?
Yeah. So what typically happens, both the styles, we believe, have got their own merits. So it's not that one against the other. In fact, they are complementary to a large extent, because as a part of your overall bouquet, you can find space for both these strategies to coexist. That's what our belief is. India is, at this point of time, we could say at the cusp, in the sense it's moving slightly more towards that mature kind of zone. Maybe it will take another decade, couple of decades for us to go to that zone. Experience tells us from the global markets, especially markets which have a much longer history than ours, that from a real long-term perspective, as the markets more and more mature, therein the passive strategies start to look much better. And possibly the active strategies may not. But from an Indian context, we think there are still a long time away from that context. So both the strategies will work at different points of time. It works for different kinds of investors. From an experience point of view, for an investor who would like to benchmark the performance of his investments with the markets, therein a fund which is slightly passive works better, because he will not have that kind of big swings, and hence the volatility part will be more or less controlled. So investors' experience will not be up and down depending upon how this. Whereas for somebody who seeks better than market returns, obviously active is the answer, because therein the fund manager, based on their ability, the fund house with their research capabilities, will be taking a slightly differentiated call, and which can obviously work from a medium term perspective also.
And Rajesh, because this is a fund of fund, the only the point that I hear, and whenever I see a fund of fund, the first thing that rings my head is actually about the extra charges. You know, so what's your thought on that? Why does an investor pay double charges? Or is it really double charge?
Sure. That's a very, very important point you've made, Ruchi. I'm sure a lot of investors also might have the same thing in their mind. First of all, even with fund of funds, there is very clear regulatory guidelines as to how much you can charge. For instance, in this fund of fund, because as I said, we are investing into passive strategies, the overall expense is capped at 1%. So when I say overall, it also includes the underlying fund charges. Because if I am going to invest in three funds here, large cap, I will invest in an ETF stroke index fund. Mid cap, I'll go for an index fund stroke ETF. Similarly for a small cap. So I'll be investing into three different funds. Okay. But inclusive of all put together, my expense will not exceed 1%, which itself makes it reasonably attractive. In fact, much cheaper than most of the other available options which you have today. So you don't have to worry. There is clear regulatory ambit even for fund of funds. So there is, even with all the charges inclusive, 1% is a reasonable number.
Okay. And Rajesh, what are your competitions or maybe a similar funds that you may be knowing or you've kind of benchmarked yourself against in the market that are available at the moment?
Sure. In fact, this is a fairly unique product. To best of my understanding, today nobody has a product mix like this, which is available. And obviously, this is, as I said, this is a category which is trying to look at the overall multi-cap space. So typically, you can benchmark it with the multi-cap kind of space from an investor's point of view. Possibly, they can even compare it with some of the multi-cap strategies around. But the only difference will be that will be all active strategies, and this is a passive strategy.
Okay.
So it's more about investment experience, what we believe will stand out for this.
And Rajiv, what kind of investors are you targeting? I know we've already talked about, but when you design a product, you have something in mind, right? So what was there in your mind that what kind of investors do you think get attracted to this kind of a fund offer?
In fact, if you recollect the first question which we discussed, I'd said it tries to offer a solution to three challenges which investors face. And I'm sure you would not be surprised to know that this is something which all investors face, irrespective of whether they are retail or HNI or well-informed investors. This dilemma is there in everybody's mind. So to our perspective, we think this suits all kinds of investors, actually. For a retail investor, this can be a part of the core portfolio itself, because normally retail investors won't have that kind of time to spend on their investments, and in the sense, they will not be able to do that much of studies and all this, and they may or may not be able to get all the advice at the right point of time. So for them, it eliminates all the need for it, because it's going to track the markets, it's coming with a relatively lower cost as well. At the same time, the allocation also is dynamic, so it tries and adjusts itself to the prevailing market situation, which is why I said that term, fill it, forget it kind of product for a retail investor. So it can be part of the core portfolio. For HNIs also, as I said, experience levels can be different, because a lot of people today also seek more consistent kind of experience in the markets. What I mean by that is not the volatility can be avoided. No, equities will always be volatile. But what they said was typically, as I said, the funds also go through their own cycle. So they put investments in a particular fund, basis some of the historical track record, and then they find the next couple of years, next 2 to 3, 4 years, it's not so been great from an experience point of view. So that can be avoided. So even from HNI's portfolio, some part of allocation can go here. For retail investors, it can be part of the core portfolio. It fits in all kinds of investors in our belief.
Thanks, Rajesh, for sharing with our viewers a lot of details about the NFO. And it was a pleasure having a discussion with you on this, and looking forward for such more interactions in future. So thanks, viewers. I hope you've understood the details of the fund offer, and definitely make your investment based on your own decision and judgment. Stay connected with Radio Dwarka.